Hello students, today we will do section D, pair of lines. First of all, intersecting lines. Whenever we are having two lines and they will cut at a point, at a common point, then that type of lines are called intersecting line. And this point P is known as point of intersection. Now next, parallel lines. Whenever we are having two lines in this way, whenever we will extend it in any direction, they will not intersect. So that type of lines which are having no point in common and they will not intersect, that lines are known as parallel lines. Now next, perpendicular lines. Whenever we are having two lines in such a way that they will intersect at a common point and they will forming 90 degree angle. See, this is 90, this is 90, this is 90, this is 90. Four right angle, then that type of lines are known as perpendicular lines. Now come to section E. Types of triangles. Triangles can be classified into two ways, according to the sides, according to the angles. So first of all, I am telling you according to side. Number one, scalene triangle. All sides unequal. See, this is scalene triangle. It's all the three sides are unequal. Second, isosceles triangle has two sides equal. See in this figure, these two sides having same sign, same mark. So these two sides are equal, but this is unequal. So this is isosceles triangle. Next, equilateral triangle has all sides equal. See, all are having same sign. Three sides are equal. So it is equilateral triangle. Now, according to the angle, acute angle triangle, in which all the three angles are less than 90, that is known as acute angle triangle. Obtuse angle triangle, see this is the figure of obtuse, in which one angle is obtuse and these two angles are acute, that is obtuse angle triangle. Right angle triangle, in which one angle is 90 degree, that is, and these two angles are acute, that is right angle triangle. In right angle triangle, see, this longest side is hypotenuse, this is base, this is altitude. Now see, section F, classification of quadrilateral. Quadrilateral means who's having four sides, 1, 2, 3, 4. Four angles, A, angle A, angle B, angle C, angle D, two diagonals, BD and AC. Four vertices, A, B, C, D. See now the types of quadrilateral. Number one, trapezium. See, this is the figure of trapezium. This. It is having four sides, 1, 2, 3, 4. These two sides are parallel sides. Second one is parallelogram. This is the figure of parallelogram. In parallelogram, opposite sides are parallel and equal. This equal to this, this equal to this. Next, rectangle. In rectangle you can say also just like a parallelogram, but in rectangle all the four angles are 90 degree and opposite sides are equal. Next, rhombus. In rhombus all the four sides are parallel and equal. Square, again you can say square is just like a rhombus. In square also four sides are equal, but in square each angle is of 90 degree, but in rhombus not. So we can say square is a parallelogram, square is a rectangle, square is a rhombus. But in square only, all the four angles are 90 degree. Next, see types of polygons. Here are some types of polygons. Triangle, three sides. Quadrilateral, four sides. Penta, five. Hexa, six. Hapta, seven. Octa, eight. Nona, nine. Deca, 10. So they are the name of the polygons according to their sides. Now, regular polygon means a regular polygon is polygon with all its sides and all its angles are equal. See, in this triangle, all the three sides are equal. All the three sides are equal and each angle is 60 degree. So, it is regular polygon, or you can say it is equilateral triangle, just like square. All the four 90 degree, all the four sides are equal, square. In pentagon, if all the five sides are equal, you will write regular pentagon. Same in regular hexagon. And if suppose in isosceles triangle only two sides are equal, in scalene no side is equal, in rectangle only opposite sides are equal. See, this is greater, this is smaller. So they are irregular polygon if side and angle are different. So okay student, complete your work. Bye bye.